Now begins to come together. On the inside, row 1, 976, Clive Richardson. On his outside of the Digger Man, it's the Dungannon Cannon, 966, Thomas Tilley. On to row 2 with the Irish Wolfhound, 175, Andy O'Donnell. Alongside him, it's the King of Carluke, that's 17, Kenny Purdy. Behind them, we have the Hammer Man, and that's 464, Mike Mead. The Yarrow Peril, the defending champion, is 9.25, and that's Gary O'Neill. Then we have Mr. Mint himself, and that's Adrian Bingo Boyle in 1.95. And we've got number 10, Podge McQuaid, Go Daddy in car 10. And to at the back we have 99, Liam Bush, the taxi driver. And the very back of there, we've got number 25, Trevor Cusack, the Irish Thoroughbred. The 2017 Irish Grand Prix for the Classic Hot Rods about to get underway. Pace car keeping well clear of the cars this time. Beginning to edge the throttle for this Classic Hot Rod big race in Tipperary tonight. Here we go! And with the scream of those engines, they thunder down the home straight for the first time, and crucially into that bend with Kenny Purdy going very, very hard indeed to stay with the two Irishmen. 976. 17, Kenny Purdy sneaks into that second place. And the big three are away as they touch the wall, going full chat up the home straight. Richardson from Purdy, Dilley. There comes 175, Andy O'Donnell, giving them a good run with his budget escort. Richardson beginning to open up a little bit of a gap, goes down the back straight once again, engine singing, and the cross flow begins to dance, trying to keep with Richardson, but Richardson is beginning to open up that little bit of a lead. Dilley closes in just a little bit, moving through turn number 2, down the back straight once again, and all the top three drivers are really motoring here. From the local team to try and stay with the big boys in first, second and third. And they're getting close again. Racing laps is a long way in hot rod racing, anything still can happen. And it's escorts 1, 2 and 3. Mark 2 is leading the way, and the big drivers are really, really battling hard as Dilley had a look up the inside of Purdy there. Really going for it, these big drivers, two of them battling for the International Series. Is firmly fixed on the top three. And Richardson opening up the lead once more. Looking for got his second title in Classic Hot Rods, having won the national title in 2016. 976. Clive Richardson now really opens it up. Kenny Purdy now falling back in second place, and then comes Thomas Dilley in third. And indeed, Andy O'Donnell is doing extremely well, keeping with them as well. Still battling though for that second place. Still not over yet for that second position. And points can be affected in this one. Dilley looking for the outside line. Oh, we have a big crash! We have a big crash! And Liam Bush clipped the wall, bounced high, but fortunately did not roll, and it brings out an instant stop to the race. Unfortunately, nobody caught the wheel that was loose. And something caused that to go. And Podge McQuaid's engine's not looking too healthy either. And Podge retiring to the infield. So after all the work that Clive Richardson had done, the distance between the drivers will come closer again as Liam Bush's poor car is looked to be removed to the safety of the infield. Drivers continuing to circulate. And Dilley's car looks like he's caught a little bit of a damage on the wing. The front bonnet has been caught. Maybe doing a little of trade of paint with Kenny Purdy. Andy O'Donnell has raced extremely well in 175, no doubt about that. And in fifth place we have 925, the defending title holder, and that is Gary O'Neill. Still, we look at seeking to safely remove the 99 car. Begin to move car 99. Lost a rear wheel as it made contact with the plating at high speed, and the rest of the traffic did extremely well to avoid that stricken car as they thundered up the home straight. The first driver to have met the situation being Clive Richardson, the race leader. So a dramatic situation, which really opens up the book again, with Podge McQuaid having retired with a sick engine, and one or two out there getting a trifle warm. we will bring it to a halt just as they remove the 99 car and we will refresh the screen.